What's going on, everyone, and welcome back to another video. My name is Richard and this is Slasher and Collectibles. Today we are going to be taking a look at the 6-scale Jawa figure from Hot Toys. Alright guys, so let's go ahead and take a quick look at the product page before we actually jump into the review. So this figure is not something that I've actually been after. I actually just saw it in one of my local stores, so I decided to go ahead and pick it up. I got this at a good, pretty decent price right around retail, so I just decided to go ahead and pick it up. So when it was first released, it did come in at a price point of $267. You also get the EG-6 Power Droid with it. And as well, and a few other accessories as well. I'm not going to go through all of it this time just because we're going to go ahead and take a look at that once we get into the review. But you do get a few accessories. You get the droid with it, and then you get the Jawa. So let's go ahead and take a quick look at some of the images here before we jump into the review. So this is everything in its entirety. You get the Jawa. Let's bring that back up. You get the Jawa, and you get the EG-6 Power Droid with it. You also get a couple bases, some hands, and the accessories. This figure also has some light-up eyes, so we'll go ahead and take a look at the light-up feature as well after we get into the review. And then one other thing I want to take a look at is current eBay prices on this thing. So currently, you can see we have some sold for $335. $419. So you're looking at about right around $300, a little bit over retail for this figure. Again, the only reason I picked it up is because I pretty much got it at that retail price. Otherwise, I wasn't really searching for this thing, or I probably wouldn't have been on eBay trying to find this to add it to my collection. But they had it displayed, and to be honest, I'm kind of running out of figures. I have a ton on pre-order, but I'm waiting for those to get shipped in. So once they get shipped, we'll look at more of the newer figures. So I'm just going to go ahead and jump right into the review, and we'll take a look at it and see if it's worth picking up. All right, guys, so here's the box for the Star Wars Jawa and EG-6 Power Droid. As you can see, all these Star Wars boxes pretty much have the same identical look to them. You have this black strip down here and then the gray on each side. You also have a Jawa image right here with the EG-6 Power Droid, some text down here, and that wraparound image. When you flip it over, you have all the legal information here on the back. I'm not going to go through all that stuff. You guys can go ahead and pause the video and take a look if you want. But I'm just going to go ahead and move on just because, like I said, most of these Star Wars boxes are pretty much the same thing. So let's go ahead and open it up and take a look inside. So when you open it up, you have this really nice image right here. I like the photography on this one. You have the Jawa and the EG-6 right there. And then once you move this top insert, you have a pretty nice view of both the Jawa and the EG-6 and some accessories there down at the bottom. If you take this part off right here, you have both of these stands there at the bottom. So I'm going to go ahead and just go ahead and take all this stuff out, and we'll lay it all out and we'll actually take a look at the figure. All right, so I went ahead and laid everything out. So let's go ahead and take a look at the bases first. So you do get two of these hexagon style bases right here. This one right here, you have the EG-6 Power Droid text on it. And then on the other one, you have the Jawa text on it. You also have these things that go right on top of the bases, so you can have more of a stylized look with some of the dirt and stuff like that that goes on it. And that just sits right on top of that. One thing I don't like about this thing is that this is like a really cheap plastic. I kind of wish they would have just made the whole entire base instead of including the hexagon style and then this insert over it. I'm not going to use these just because these feel like really flimsy and cheap. It's like a really cheap type plastic on it. Not a huge fan of how they did that, but I guess if you want to use it, you can't really tell. I actually didn't know it was like that until I opened it up. I thought you got this was the entire base itself, but it's not. It's just an insert that goes right on top of it. All right, guys, so let's go ahead and move on to some of these accessories. You do get a blaster rifle with some weathering on it, which looks pretty nice. You have a really nice dark brown tone right here. And then the blaster rifle has this nice black with weathering all across it. Looks pretty nice. I'm definitely going to be using this when I pose it. I actually really like the way that this one looks. All right, so take a look at these two. So you also get the Jawa welder with it. Pretty nice colors. You got the green and the red up there with this nice gold and silver. And you also get the Jawa communicator. All All right, so let's go ahead and start taking a look at these two things. So the first thing we're going to start with is the EG-6 Power Droid. This is just plastic. These have a little bit of movement in the legs right here, but really not too much. I think you can probably... I mean, this thing doesn't really have that much movement anyway, but you do get a little bit of articulations here in the leg. The dirt and everything looks really nice on this, so the weathering effect and the paint look pretty nice for what it is, but you do just get a hollow plastic piece for it. Pretty good sculpting and detail throughout the entire thing. But this is pretty much all it is. You also have some nice weathering right here with throughout the metal feet, which look pretty nice. And then you also have this thing right here that moves it kind of like so that you can move the legs around and that's not going to get restricted. This thing does go inside the piece here, so you have a little bit of pull if you want to pull that out, if you want to have his legs displayed in different angles. As for the Jawa looks pretty good. You do get a smaller style body with it, and then you get this brown tunic, which looks pretty nice. You have a little bit of weathering here throughout the entire piece, which they did a pretty good job on it. You also get a wire right in here, so if you want to, however you want to pose that, you can play around with it a little bit to get a nice look to it. The head, let's see if I can pull this back really quick. It's about as far as I can go, but here, the head... You do see, you just get this black head. These eyes do light up. I'll put the batteries here in a second and we'll take a look. There's going to be no restriction throughout the movement here just because of the way that the tunic is. Get some pretty good articulation throughout the entire piece here. Then you also get this darker brown undershirt right here. And then some pretty good sculpting here on the feet. As for the hands, you get one set that comes on it, so you have some open hands to hold some of his accessories. And then you also get three other hands right here. One is going to be just a relaxed hand. You also get a hand that's going to be holding the rifle, and then you get a gesture hand if you want to use those. I'll probably have him holding the rifle, just because I like the way that piece looks, but... You do get other hands if you want to use the different accessories. All right, and so for the light up feature to get the batteries in, what you do is just you got to remove this hood back. There is some Velcro right there that is attached. You just go ahead and peel that off. Once you get that peeled off, you can go ahead and unscrew this battery compartment right here and you can insert the batteries for the light up feature. So I'm going to go ahead and put the batteries in there really quick and we'll see what he looks like with the light up feature. And I'm going to stop the camera real quick and we'll take a look at the light up feature. Alright, so I went ahead and put the batteries inside the head. So let's go ahead and turn this on and you can see. So there is a switch here in the back. I'm not going to take this back. You can feel it right through the cloth here. And go ahead and turn that on and you can see the light up feature. These lights are pretty bright, so you really can't see it too much. So let me go ahead and take these lights off really quick and we'll take a look. Alright, so you can see a little bit better. With the lights off, it's still a little bit bright inside the room, so it still looks a little bit faded, but you can see these eyes light up almost like an orangish color, which look pretty nice. And then if you have this hood over to hide kind of that black, you'll get that whole effect where it's just like almost pure black with just the light up. So I'm gonna go ahead and just jump right into getting this guy posed up and we'll kind of see what we can get out of it. I'll be right back and we'll pose it up. Thank you. Thank you guys so much, and I hope you guys enjoyed today's review of the 1/6 scale Jawa figure. If you guys like what you saw, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys all in the next video.